Hello everybody and welcome back to another new video, and this is your Premier League predictions for match week 16. And I actually haven't kept count of the match weeks really. I think it's either 15 or 16. I'm pretty sure it's 16, but count me if I'm wrong. Also, sorry for no predictions for the midweek Premier League matches, as I just didn't really find the time to make them predictions. So yeah, sorry about that. The next midweek fixtures, when they come around, I will make videos for them. However, let's just drive straight back into the weekend fixtures, and starting off as the London Derby, West Ham United versus Chelsea. Chelsea blew a lead against Man United, but they came back and drew 1-1 that game. A pretty tight game where Chelsea dominated in that one. West Ham still looking good, however, back-to-back defeats in the Premier League isn't looking good. By the way, I'm recording this on Tuesday, so before all these midweek fixtures happen, so that's why I'm not talking about the midweek fixtures really. So anyway, back in the video. It's going to be a tricky match, both sides in good form. However, I'm going to say Chelsea will grind out a tricky 1-0 win here at the London Stadium. And I'm going to say it'll be Kai Havertz finding the score sheet in this one to get Chelsea all 3 points. Nothing much will happen in it, however, it will be a tight match and there'll be a few nerve-wracking moments near the end. And now we go to Newcastle versus Burnley, and Eddie Howe began his new career at Newcastle with a 2-0 defeat at Arsenal. Pretty poor really, but it is Arsenal, so you have to expect that. Burnley's match against Tottenham was postponed. Big Sean Dyche, a madman going out in the snow with just a suit on, you know. But that was postponed against Tottenham because of the snow, of course. However, here up at Tyneside, I'm going to say Newcastle get a 2-1 win. They get it together and they get a 2-1 win. And Callum Wilson is going to be the best player on that pitch. I think under Eddie Howe again, he'll gain loads of confidence and he'll bag 2 goals in this game to help the town to all 3 points. And now let's go to the South Coast Derby at Southampton versus Brighton. Now, let's see. Brighton drew 0-0 with Leeds. Graham Potter's in the mud, really. Brighton need to pick up the form because, honestly, it's not looking good for them. Southampton are also a crushed 4-0 by Liverpool. But yeah, that's Liverpool, so let's just not talk about that. And I'm going to say here it'll be another draw for the Seagulls away at Southampton. They'll finish 1-1 in this game. And I'm going to say it'll be key moments back in the back line. Lianco, I'm going to say, will be the man of the match for Southampton, the Brazilian centre-back. I'm going to say he'll have a good performance and he'll help Southampton get a good clean sheet, but of course I said it'll be 1-1, but he will help them get a draw at least. And now let's go to Wolves versus Liverpool. Liverpool, of course, we already talked about them crushing Southampton. Wolves are in good form, actually. Wolves are in very good form at the moment. So I wouldn't be surprised if they pulled the shocker and got a draw here. However, I'm going to say I've finished 2-0 Liverpool, an easy win for Klopp. I am going to say the main performers will be Diogo Jota, who's picking up the form again. He'll get a goal in this one. And I'm also going to say Thiago Alcantara, who's been in good form, he will get an assist in this game to help Liverpool on the way to a 2-0 win. And now let's go to Watford versus Manchester City. Poor Watford, honestly. They lost 4-2 to Leicester last time out. Man City beat West Ham 2-1. But every time Man City plays Watford, poor Watford, they just get slapped about the place. They get battered. And that's going to be the same here. 5-1 defeat, I'm going to say, for Watford. And Man City are going to go and absolutely tear Watford apart at the Vicarage Road. And I'm going to say the two main performers will be Kevin De Bruyne, who will get 1 goal and 1 assist in this game. I think he will get more goal contributions to his tally. And I'm going to say there'll be a hat-trick in this game. And the hat-trick will be scored by Riyad Mahrez. I really fancy him to have a stellar performance and to get a hat-trick to help Man City absolutely annihilate Watford in this game. And now let's go to Leeds United versus Brentford. Leeds United, of course, they drew 0-0 with Brighton. Brentford, however, they beat Everton 1-0. Good win for them, however, Everton are in bad form. I'm going to say it'll be another 1-0 win for Brentford here away at Elland Road. Of course, it'll be another tight game between the battle of the two great championship promoted sides. But I'm going to say it'll be an Ivan Toney goal that separates both sides and a 1-0 win for the Bees. And now let's go to Manchester United versus Crystal Palace. And this is going to be Ralph Rangnick's first game in charge of Manchester United. And despite Crystal Palace doing good at the moment, boy oh boy, he's licking his lips and is looking for a thrashing. I am going to say United are going to look like their old selves again. And they're going to win here comfortably 3-0 against Crystal Palace. The main performers are going to be Bruno Fernandes, who will get a brace of assists in this one. I think Bruno Fernandes is going to cope well under Rangnick. He'll get 2 assists in this game. Morata added his tally. I'm going to say Jadon Sancho will also get another goal in this game. He's starting to pick up the form. I'd say he score again here. And I think Edinson Cavani is going to get a goal in this one. I think Ryan will like Cavani. I think he's going to play a wee bit in this game and he will get a goal under the gegenpressing format. A 3-0 win. And let's go to Tottenham versus Norwich. And Conte still, of course, is struggling at Tottenham. They lost 2-1 to Mura, who are some side from Slovenia that I had never heard of until they were drawn in the Conference League. I mean, that is poor, even for Antonio Conte. That just proves that the Tottenham side is not full of quality, really. However, here against Norwich, despite Norwich having back-to-back wins in the league, I'm going to say it'll finish a 3-1 win against Norwich. And I'm going to say the main protagonist in this one will be Harry Kane, who will get 2 goals against his former side in Norwich. And let's go to Aston Villa versus Leicester City. Stevie G's done decent enough with Villa. However, I said this last week, I'll say it this week, this will be his first taste of English football. I'm going to say it'll be the battle of the former Old Firm coaches, and Brendan Rodgers, the former Celtic coach, will get the better of the former Rangers one. It'll finish 2-1 at Villa Park. And I'm going to say the main performer will be Patson Daka, who will get 1 goal in this game, and Yuri Tielemans, who will also get an assist. And finally, let's go to Everton versus Arsenal. Everton, 7 games without a win. Rafa Benitez is under some pressure. However, Arteta's pressure's eased off a long, long ago, and Arsenal are really flying high now. And I'm going to say Arsenal, it's going to be an easy win here at Goodison Park. The end of the video, I'm going to say it'll finish 2-0 for Arsenal, with Bukayo Saka getting 1 goal and 1 assist. As the end of the video, I hope you did enjoy. Remember to like, share, and subscribe, and turn on notifications, as I always ask you to do. I'll see you in my next video.